first quick costume is just going to be a cowgirl, which is very simple if you just have the basic stuff for it. All you're going to need is a cowgirl hat, which you can literally get anywhere for very cheap as well. Any type of denim or plaid, even if you have that, which I think everyone has, like a flannel. And just a simple shirt. And you're just going to need some jean shorts. I didn't want to wear jean on jean, so I wore black shorts. And any type of brown booty or cowgirl boots or even just regular boots. But I love my cowgirl boots, but I just wanted to be me and wear my booty because I love my booties. Then the next costume idea would just be any type of sports player, really, but it's a volleyball player in this case. All you're going to really need is a bow to wear in a bun, like a lot of volleyball players do that, or you can just put it in a ponytail with that one. And then all you're going to need is a volleyball, of course, because duh, you're a volleyball player, might as well carry around a volleyball. And then a jersey of any type. I just got this from like a friend that had one. And then spandex, because they literally just wear spandex. And then any type of, like, I would say ugly tennis shoe, because their shoes are not that cute. No offense. Love you guys. The next outfit is going to be a Barbie doll, which is very simple. If you're blonde already, it's like prime. All you're going to need is some hair extensions if your hair is not that long, because Barbie always has really nice long hair. To spice up your look, you're just going to want some sunglasses, just because Barbie is always fab and you want to be fab just like her. Then you're just going to need some cute bling bling jewelry. I have this heart necklace that's very blingy and it's very cute, and then these bracelets that, I don't know, they just kind of represent Barbie, I think. You're gonna need any type of pink dress, preferably tight. I don't know, Barbie would just wear pink, I guess. It's just her color. And then any type of heel and just a purse. Then this outfit's really fun. It's just a jazzercise, which is like a really fun outfit and it's very comfortable. All you're gonna need is some colorful leggings, a leotard, which you can get from literally the Goodwill. It doesn't even look like that, just a black one even. Some socks, which I just cut, so they're kind of like leg warmers. And then a scrunchie or a headband or both, whatever. If you don't have a leotard, you can literally just wear like an off-the-shoulder top with like a sports bra and it'll look good. And then just some tennis shoes. The next outfit would be Risky Business, which is a really funny movie if you haven't seen it. I'm just wearing my hair in this really messy bun type of look, just because, you know, it's Risky Business, I don't really care. And then this really long, big button-up t-shirt, which I just got from Goodwill, but you can literally get it from your dad's closet if he lets you wear it. Then I put some white Spanx under there, just because, you know, I don't really want to show everyone my underwear, so you gotta have those, and then some socks, which is the cliche Risky Business outfit, and some shoes, just because I don't want to go around barefoot. The last outfit is going to be a comic book character, and this was very difficult for me, actually, as you can see by the makeup. I just wore a polka dot with like daisy shirt, just because I needed to follow the polka dot looking vibe for a comic character, and a pencil skirt, which is very simple, and then just some boots. The type of look that girls that just want to do their makeup for Halloween kind of go for, you know, kind of the basic look. But if you like work somewhere and you're supposed to dress up, this is just a nice outfit because you can wear it to work and be appropriate. But you can also look great with your makeup and your wig. So I'm just starting off by outlining my jaw with this eyeliner, and then I start outlining other things like my nose and over my Cupid's bow and my lips, and I kind of overdraw them just because you want your lips to look voluptuous, right? And then I kind of did my eyebrows a little over drastic, as you'll see, but I mean, they turned out good and I thought it was kind of fun. And then your polka dots aren't going to be perfect, and you can literally use anything for this, paint, face paint, or, you know, the jumbo eye pencil works great. But your polka dots aren't going to be perfect, and over time I realized that they're not going to be perfect, and I just kind of randomly did them after a while because I just didn't really care. Then you're just going to add like random little kind of comic character looking things. I don't really know how to explain that. And like under eye lashes, and I tried to do like an eye look type of thing, but like not really. It was just kind of, it just turned out really messy. I'm just gonna say that for the least. And then I added some weird eyelashes things. It was just weird. Like, just don't even comment about it. I honestly look like a clown. Like, it's okay if you guys don't like this. I just added some tears because I wanted to be a sad comic character. So sad. Then I just added this Urban Decay.
Quick step back.
Red.
I am using a wig from apphair.com. You can find their wigs on apphair.com. They're really cute and good for Halloween season. I got, here it is. It's a really nice wig. It's like a bob looking wig, and I thought it'd be perfect for this type of look. I am going to be putting some tears in my eyes.
But yeah, so I just added my teardrops, and then there I am. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and if you guys want the promo code for this website for the wig, then I'll put that down below. And I hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye!